You know, I wasn't really thinking about I want to do a music movie. It was really specifically that I was fascinated by Hank Williams. Grew up listening to country music, became interested in his music, read about him, and even as a young man found his life to be extraordinarily painful and interesting. And I just thought he was a brilliant poet, and ultimately thought it would make a good story. And, you know, not somebody that, you know, yes, there's a lot of people that know about Hank Williams or whose grandparents knew about Hank Williams, but not somebody that, like my sons knew about. I mean, they can tell you what, you know, a lot about 50 Cent. And they can tell you a lot about Snoop and Biggie, and because they're rap fans, obviously. But they don't know anything about Hank Williams. And it's not like my job is to educate the universe, but I just thought, wow, what a really interesting, accessible story about a powerful young artist, one of the most important voices of the 20th century in terms of poetry, a story of addiction, a story of really, really tumultuous relationships. I don't know, to me it seemed like good, the real basis for a powerful movie.
And you're a storyteller, and you also think Hank Williams is also a storyteller through his music, and that was his biggest motive in writing music?
I think he's a brilliant storyteller. I mean, I really do. I think Hank Williams, like Bob Dylan, is a genius. You know, I think there's no question about it. I mean, that to me, and I don't use the word lightly, but there are a lot of powerful voices through the years. Amazing storyteller. I mean, you can't listen to I'm So Lonesome I Could Cry and not hear the story behind it, or Cold, Cold Heart and not understand. You know, Hey Good Looking is a great pickup line. It's not a great story, but Why Don't You Love Me Like You Used to Do, or, you know, I Can't Help, you know, Fall in Love with You. I mean, there are songs that are so powerful and really do tell you about the human condition.
And how did Tom and Elizabeth both each capture the essence of the character so well?
Well, you know, they're both fantastic actors, and they're really serious actors. They're not people who they really, really, really are focused. And they both independently did their research, but then they just absorbed it in their bodies, had very strong opinions about what they wanted to be able to convey, and were very open to the collaboration with me. I love working with actors. To me, that's the most important job of a director, really, is to ultimately get the performances. And we talked a lot about it. We had some time for a rehearsal. But in the end, an actor reaches deep inside themselves to find what it is in the character that they can most relate to, and then hopes to be able to convey it in the most genuine fashion. Just genuine, like feel the anger, feel the pain, feel the frustration, feel the laughter, feel the beauty of being able to say to someone, I know in the scene when Elizabeth tells him that he's having a baby, because I've had a lot of children and she's never had any, and she said, well, how do you want to do this? I said, you know what, you're only ever going to get to tell a person, your husband, once that he's having a baby. The first time, you're going to tell him again, but he's never going to hear that but one time that you're pregnant, that he's finally going to have a child. That's his first child. And so take your time. And you can watch that scene, and I took a lot, and Lizzie takes a lot of time doing it. And I said, just, and she found, you watch her as a real character find the moment when she's prepared to say that one gem, to just say, okay, here it is. I'm never get to say this to you again. So that's a really talented actor, being able to assimilate the information, put it in their own terms, and then ultimately give it back. And it's my job to watch it and be able to look at them and give them the feedback that lets them know whether they accomplished that.